Good morning. Welcome to All Saints Church. Welcome to All In. My name's David. I'm one of the team, and it's really good to have you with us as we gather to worship together this morning. Hopefully you've got the kettle on. Hopefully you've got a cup of tea on the go. If you are here and want to chop in a comment and say hello, please do. It's really good for us to check in with each other, for me to see who's listening and for me to say hello. I'll just make my coffee that I've got here. I hope you've had a good week. It's been a really sunny week, hasn't it? I've been in the garden quite a lot, having a good time. Did a bit of chopping and weeding and trampolining. Those of you that see me on Facebook might see some of the TikTok videos that me and Kimberly have had a go at creating. There's nothing like people in their 30s trying to be on TikTok, is there? Hi, Liz. Hi, Sarah. It's good to see you both. Hope you're well. Hope you're good. If you are just kind of logging on, there's 14 of us now. If you are just logging on, you might want to grab something to write with and some post-it notes. There's your clue. So something to write with and some post-it notes. Morning, Liz. Good to see you. And I'm doing really well because I've spilled a bit of my coffee so far, but I'm sure it'll all be fine. Good morning, Lynn. Morning, Alice. Morning, Liz. Good to see you. Hi, Helen. Hi, Rosemary. As you can see on this side, we've got some of our notices scrolling. We are still up to stuff, even though we're still on lockdown. So if you've got little people with you, kind of maybe six-year-olds and under, or people that like singing, why not join our All Saints Babies and Toddlers group? And on Wednesday and Thursday morning, hi Pam, hi Pauline, hi Mary, good to see you. On Wednesday and Thursday mornings at 10:30, we have a short story and some music, and some puppets as well. Hi John, hi Laura, hi Caroline, all the way from Tenerife again. I hope you're enjoying the sun. Ours has disappeared now, so I hope you've got it. Hi Helen. And as the notice says here, we've got our YouTube channel. So everything that we do online goes onto our YouTube channel. And sometimes we split it up a bit as well. So if you'd rather just catch up on a sermon or just hear some of the music, that's on there as well. Alternatively, you can watch the whole thing again and join in. And most of our services, I think all of our services are on there. We've got our kind of BCP services from St. Catherine's. They're on every Sunday morning from 9. You can catch up. We've got an Explore service still up there. Hi, Peter. Oh, my wife's saying hello to me. Hi, Kimmy. Well, I think everyone else can hear me, can't they? So it might be you, guy. I will just check. Hi, Pam. Hi, Doug. Hi Sue, hi Barry, hi Nigel. Can you hear me, Kimmy? On the thing? Yeah, I've just checked, Guy. I think it's probably your sound that isn't working. Hi Chrissy, sorry I missed you there. We were scrolling too quickly. Have I missed anyone? Hi Heather. I just have to point out that if we do get invaded by a little person with blonde hair, we can't currently contain them in the garden particularly because the weather isn't good enough. So they are next door doing some crafty stuff. But that's family, right? That's noise, that's fun. Hi, Karen. Good to see you. Hi, Liz. Hi, Andrew. Oh, Nigel can hear me. That's good. Lucky Nigel. Those of you that were here last week did miss the about 5 minutes of a sermon that no one could hear, which I think someone said was probably the best sermon they've ever seen me give, which was very kind of them. Hi, Sally. Hi, Tabby. Anyway, I was saying about our notices. So we've got lots of stuff kind of going on during the week on here. This is a notice about our food bank. So we are, a few of us from the church are working in kind of coordination with food bank. There's a couple we look at. There's one in Telford in Sutton Hill, and there's one over in Dorley. And I've got a car full at the moment, so thank you so much to those of you. Literally a car full. I could probably fit in five more tins of beans. So that's really kind of you, those that have given toiletries and cash donations for the food bank and shopping. And I'll be taking them to both the food banks this week. But I'm thank you and encouragement to keep going with that. That needle keep going. But it's so encouraging to have so much stuff. And they are so thankful to all of you and to those in your community who might not come to church but are seeing a need to help out. This is our diary of all the stuff that we've got going on in church over the week. So there's morning and evening prayer and Bible study on a Wednesday night. So do join in. Who else have we got? Lots of people checking in now. We've got Lynn. Hi, Lynn. We've got Sue. Hi, Sue. Hi, Julie. Hi, other Sue. And I think my mum and dad have texted my wife to say they're watching, but they're not on Facebook. So hi, mum. Hi, dad. Hope Norfolk's sunny. We'll be starting in, 5 minutes? So you've got time, 4 minutes. So you've got time to grab a cuppa if you haven't. And if you missed me, say this. You might want, well, you will, I'd like you to get, if you can, a pen and some post-it notes. And you'll find out why later. And if you've got some little people with you, we really hope that this service is, as it's called, all in, for all ages and all stages. So there'll be lots of stuff to keep them entertained with the screen, we hope. But there are also some crafts to go with it. So we know that not everyone likes sitting and looking at a screen. That doesn't always engage people. Some of them might really be doing something while they're listening. So if you go onto our Facebook page, I think it's a post below, Caroline has put on some crafts for you to get on with if you'd like to. And we'd love you to maybe message in some pictures of them. It's really good to see what you get up to. Hi, Jackie. Hi, Rick. Hi, Dorothy. Maddie. If you haven't shared this, please do. We're seeing an amazing amount of people hearing the good news of Jesus that wouldn't otherwise come to church. Morning, Val. So I'd really encourage you to share this, to just share it on your newsfeed or your story, and to encourage your people who you're friends with to join in. You can just do that by clicking the share button that's probably underneath, to the right maybe, of the video that you're watching. And other people might want to come and hear. You never know what people are doing on Facebook at home. So please do that. If you haven't, we'd love you to share it. We're seeing an amazing and exciting amount of people hearing that God loves them that wouldn't necessarily hear. Hi, Dave. Hi, Michaela. Hi, Karen. Nikki. And if you don't follow our Facebook page, please do that afterwards. Please do like it and follow it. As we speak, a message has come up from, oh wow, Emily, that's amazing. I'm not going to try and share that because everything might go horribly wrong on my computer, but I'll share it afterwards. I've had an amazing picture sent in from Emily of cake, me on a big screen, that's a bit scary, and cake. Happy days, that's all you need, isn't it? Church, cake, happy days. Morning, Keith. Good to have you, Keith. Keith was Tim's training incumbent over in Burnwood. Hi, Helen. Hi, Gemma. Hope Tamworth area is treating you guys well. Hi, Andrew. Oh, Chris, that's really harsh because church with sausage sandwiches. Well, you know where I live, and I know that we're not allowed to go out apart from for essential business, but well, takeaways, I'm not sure that counts as essential, actually, to be fair. But the idea of a sausage sandwich with tomato sauce, you know, tomato or brown sauce, what do we reckon? Maybe we're going to be ending in a minute, but maybe that could be a way of ending our conversation. Tomato or brown sauce on your sausage sandwich. I like runny fried egg with tomato sauce. That's the way it's got to be, with a nice black coffee. Hi, Lucy. Hi, Margaret. Hi, Charlotte. Hi, Philip. I'm sorry that your Facebook watch isn't working. You might just want to click off and start again. That's a bit strange. Hi, May. Sauce phobic. Oh dear. I guess they're good sausages. You don't want to spoil them in tomato ketchup. Okay, so we're going to start with our countdown video in a minute. If you haven't yet, if you're just joined us and you haven't got a pen or a post-it note, please do use the countdown video to find a pen or a pencil and some post-it notes. You just need one. If you can't get a post-it note, a bit of paper will do. That's absolutely fine. But that would be great. Mustard. Oh, Tim, that's a curveball. Mustard. Okay. So let's make a start, shall we? Kicking off in the comments, we're not talking about Jesus, we're talking about condiments and sausage sandwiches, which has nothing to do with the service this morning, but it's good to share anyway. It's good to share what we're feeling. For the record, I'm more of a tomato sauce kind of man, to be honest, but if it's a good sausage, I don't want to spoil it with sauce. But anyway, let's move on, shall we? Welcome to All In, our service kind of for all ages and stages, a bit more informal. We've got a lot of stuff going on today. We've got some videos to share with you, some stories, some activities. If you're here for the first time or you're logging on for the first time, a real welcome to All Saints Church in Wellington. We hope that you feel really part of the family this morning as we gather all over the country. I think our furthest person this morning is tuning in from Tenerife. Happy days. But wherever you are, I'm sat at my dining table, the children are next door, having a bit of fun, doing some craft activities. But whatever you're doing, we pray that this day will be a blessing for you. If you have got little ones with you, if you go down a Facebook post below, you'll see some craft activities for them to do. And as if by magic, I've just spoken about my four-year-old and he's wanting to come and find me. So apologies if at any time the door opens and I get invaded by Arthur. That's absolutely fine, isn't that? That's family. Over the last few months during All In, what we've been looking at, the logos on this hand side, we've been thinking about how we are gathered together. We're not at the moment, but when we started the series, we were gathered together and then we're scattered. But wherever we're scattered to on our front lines, we are called, wherever we are, whenever we're there, whatever we're doing, we're called to be ministers. We're called to be people that see God's kingdom come and that speak to people and show people of God's love. And that's what we're thinking about today. Today we're thinking that whoever we are, God can use us. And his intention is that we get to see his kingdom come. So with that in mind, the idea of whoever we are, what I'd like you to do during the first song, which is a kid's song, it's quite fun, you want to get up and get active. I've got a nip next door for the thing after the song. So I'll be doing that while the song's playing. But what I'd like you to do with your pen and your post-it note that hopefully you've got, and if you haven't managed to get it, you can grab one during the song. On the top half of your post-it note here, on the top half, just write down a word that you would use to sum up who you are. A word that you would use, and that's all I'm going to say, a word that you would use to sum up who you are. And write it on top of this post-it note. Leave a space underneath it for me. And while you're doing that, while you're writing that down in your post-it note, you might want to comment up, you might want to write it in the comments as well, that'd be good. We're going to sing our first song. If you know the actions, join in. I can't show them to you because I'm nipping next door. But do join in if you know them.
Thank you. Okay, so we've managed to hide from the children for a few minutes. I've nipped off into the lounge. If they do come in, I apologise, but we'll see if this works or not. And me and Kimberly are going to play a little party game. Now, the problem is Kimberly, by her own admission, isn't particularly good at this game. So we've had to make it a bit easier. But it's one of those games where you stick something on your forehead and the other person has to help you work out who you are. And you can ask 20 questions.
Yeah.
20 questions, and it's yes or no answers to find out who you are. Now, I've had to narrow it down a bit to the topic of CBeebies. I'm just trying to work out if I can work out Kimberly's favourite CBeebies character or not. Or maybe she's gone off on a curveball. And you're not allowed to just have 20 guesses at the person. That's cheating. Maybe you have two guesses. Two guesses. If you get one wrong, you can carry on, but it counts as one of your goes. So, and obviously we can kind of might be able to see. So I think I'm going to go first. I'm going to have the blindfold. So Kimmy's got one of her blindfolds and I'm going to put it on. That's a bit weird because all I can see is this pink stuff. Okay, I definitely can't see.
Ready for your name?
Yep. So, is it sticking on?
It's on.
So, hopefully, everyone at home, you can see who or what it is. Do you want me to hold it? Oh, that's a good idea. Okay. Am I a male?
No.
Are you sure?
No.
So, I'm not. Okay. Am I human?
No.
Oh. Am I an animal?
No.
What? I bet you've googled CBeebies characters and got the most obscure one. Am I animated?
Yeah.
Oh, is it something ridiculous? Am I a ridiculously... Am I like a puppet type character?
No.
Am I real life?
No.
Oh my goodness. I hope you're counting. Am I... A funny character?
Kind of, yes.
Am I an angry character?
No.
Do I do a lot of active things?
It could be called active.
Okay. I'm probably running out of time, really quick. Do I live in one place or live in lots of different places?
You live in one place.
Do I live in a house?
Hold on, that's not allowed. As a yes or
no
question.
Sorry, never mind. Do I live in a house?
No.
Oh, okay. Do I live anywhere?
Yeah.
Am I red?
Oh, that's a good question. No.
Am I blue?
I think so.
I'm going to have a guess.
Okay.
Am I a Teletubby?
Oh, no.
Oh.
You're not far off the mark.
Am I Nunu?
Yeah. Yes.
That was really funny. Finally, I got it. Great. Okay. Right, now it's my turn. So I'm going to write something for Kimberly to guess. Kimberly's going to write it on. Gosh, that was a ridiculous one, wasn't it? That was just. I mean. Okay. Here we go. Right. Okay. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm not sure anyone there can read my writing, but let me hold it up. There you go, that's who it is. Right. Okay, go.
Okay, am I a human?
Yes.
Am I an adult?
Yes.
Ooh. Am I female?
Yes.
Oh, is my favourite question, do you know?
No. Oh. I wish.
I'm female. Do I like vehicles?
Not really, kind of apathetic. I know who you're thinking.
Am I Scottish?
Maybe.
Oh.
No, you're not.
No. Do I have children?
Don't know. Not as far as I'm aware.
In the CBeebies thing?
Yes, obviously.
Okay.
You have two in real life.
Oh gosh.
Come on.
I'm trying to think. I can't think of anything.
I told you she was very good.
Do I? Oh gosh. Do I sing?
No.
Am I a CBB presenter?
No.
I have absolutely no idea who it is.
You've got 11 more questions. Do you have a guess?
But I don't know who it is, so I can't guess.
What would you ask? Put it in the comments. It won't help her, but I can ask. Well, if you've got a guess in the comments. Again, she won't be able to know.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, of course you've got a guess. You know who it is.
Am I?
I'm going to say timey.
Oh, five. No. Okay. Am I Topsy and Tim's mum? No, I don't have children. I can't be.
Two.
One. I don't know.
You're Mrs. Goggins.
Of course I am.
Well, we're going to go and round. We're going to go and round up our children, and I'll catch you in a minute.
Thank you.
Amen. Yes, Lord, you are a good, good Father. Maybe a moment of prayer before we continue. Father, we thank you that you are a good, good Father. And wherever we are today, wherever we are scattered, we pray that we would know your presence with us. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Right, well, we've got a bit of a quiz coming up now. As you can hopefully see on this hand side, you've got some... Oh, that side, there you go. You've got some pictures, and I'm going to show you two or three pictures of people, and you need to try and work out who their celebrity parents are. So they've got a mum or dad who are famous. And so what I'm going to ask you to do is in the comments, and we've got some prizes. We've got some prizes. There they are. Whoops. Now, unfortunately, we've got three prizes to give out for the three pictures of chocolate. Obviously, you won't be able to get there because you can't do it. So Lucy has already won the first prize, but obviously, as I can't get this to her, I will eat it on her behalf. So Lucy, well done. Thank you. Mm. And the really sad thing is, Lucy can't really have milk, but that's some dark chocolate. It's Bourneville. But let's have a look. We've got lots of guesses for Reese Witherspoon. Ta-da! It is indeed. It's the daughter of Reese Witherspoon. Lucy, thank you very much for the chocolate. It's very kind of you. Well done, Caroline. Well done, Charlotte. Anyone else get that was Reese Witherspoon? Legally Blonde films. There are lots of other films she's in, isn't there? A Sweet Home Alabama or something like that. Let's have the next one. Any idea? Who do we reckon? No guesses yet. No, still no guesses. Come on, I'm hungry. Yes, Claire! Got it in one. Although Michaela, I guess Michaela is kind of more accurate in terms of posh ambex. But yes, I'll give it to Claire. You win. You get the next one. Lucy's, yours is empty. Claire, thank you very much. Appreciate it. Let's check your rhyme. Yes. I'm not much of a football guru, but doesn't he still play? Even though he's like older than most footballers, I think he still plays for... AC Florida American team? I've literally got no idea who he plays for. But yes, well done. I think who was the winner there? Lots of you are getting it right. But I think Claire, you got there first. Well done, Claire. Yes, you're spot on Richard. His name's Romeo. But that's great. Last one. Oh, any idea who that's the daughter of? Well, Liz, you better answer one of my questions. Oh, Karen, I'm not sure who Mirella Streep is, but I'll give it to you. I think Karen, despite the typo, Karen wins. Lucy was a close second. Sue, you've got it. Sarah, yes, Liz, Caroline, Ali. I think somebody might have seen it because I pressed the wrong button. But there we go. Meryl Streep. Karen, well done. This one's yours. I'll eat it for you. The rest of you have finished. I'm feeling a little bit queasy now. But there we go. So you might be thinking, what on earth, why have you got me to do that? Well, what I'd like you to do is look back at the label you wrote for yourself right at the beginning. So grab it, have a look at it, remind yourself of the word. And you wrote a word on there that described you. And I wonder if you did that maybe, sorry, I'm just reading the comments, which are really distracting, because I just seen Liz Carter write metal sheep, I think. Oh no, metal streep. Okay, metal sheep would be even better. Anyway, back in the room. Come on, focus. Ignore Facebook. Ignore the comments. Stop talking to me, everyone. Hopefully you wrote a name on the, a word on the post-it note that described you or summed up kind of your identity. That was what I asked you to do, wasn't it? A word that talked about who you are. And you might have done that based on a job or something you like to do or a hobby. You might have defined yourself based on your relationship with other people. You might have just written your name. Maybe you did it based on faith, on the fact that you're maybe, whatever you believe, maybe if you're a disciple of Jesus this morning, that was something that you wrote down. It'd be great for you to comment and write, what did you write on your post-it note? Let's share some of them in the comment stream. What did you put on your post-it note? The reason we've just done that silly little quiz is to remind ourselves that it's not just us who affect our identity. It's other people as well sometimes, isn't it? So we had examples here of children that looked like their mums and dads. And some of you might resemble your parents, I don't know. Some of you might not. For those of us that are in maybe kind of blended families, maybe step families or adoptive families, we don't always look, we don't often actually look like both of our parents, maybe both of our new parents. But there was a really interesting kind of medical study done in a journal a couple of years ago, which said this, and it's really interesting. It says that children who are adopted into families, even if they don't look like their new mum and dad or their new parents, as they spend time with them, not only do they turn kind of more like them in terms of personality, but there's real good evidence, scientific evidence, to show that their facial features and their hair colour sometimes when they're young can change to be more like that of their primary caregivers, their new parents. Isn't that amazing? Because the people that we surround ourselves with also affect who we are, also affect our identity. But it's more than that. Because ultimately, we should get our identity from our Heavenly Father. Our Heavenly Father tells us who we are. So despite what we might say about ourselves, what we might label ourselves, and we've got some labels here of Christian, conscientious, mum or dad, empathetic, child of God, me, mum, lots of really good definitions maybe that sum up kind of who we are or give an element of who we are. But and there's also other people that affect who we are. It might be our parents or our family or our friends who, like the quiz we just had with the pictures, influence what people look like or who they are or what they do. But there's more than that. Our Heavenly Father affects our identity. And I've got here some words of who we are in Jesus. So despite the labels we might give ourselves, despite the labels that other people or family or friends might give us, or we might look like them or resemble them, above it all, here are some truths that the Bible tells us about ourselves. And what I'd like to do while I'm reading these out is I'd like you to think of one that resonates with you this morning and write it on your post-it note. In a minute, Tim's going to share with us some kind of challenges that this will bring. But at the moment, we're thinking of the blessings, maybe, that it can bring. So I'm going to read them out. And what I'd like you to do is write down underneath at the bottom of your post-it note the one that jumps out to you, the one that you needed to hear today. And they say we're sons and daughters of the King. And that's the one above it all, that we're his children. We're his heirs. I talked about that last week. If you were here, you might have remembered it, or if not, jump onto our website or YouTube, and I talked about what it meant to be heirs of the kingdom and our inheritance that God invites us to have now, to share with now. Sons, daughters, brothers, sisters, first fruits, heirs, children of Abraham, holy chosen people, disciples, believers, servants and saints, strangers, prophets, aliens, priests, temples of the Holy Spirit, ministers of a new covenant, witnesses, light of the world, daughters and sons, ambassadors of the King. Wow, that's who I am. That's who you are this morning. If you don't believe me, I'm going to read out a couple of passages from the Bible that say similar things. And while I'm doing that, as I said, you might want to comment some of those words that jump out at you. You might want to write one down, please, on your post-it note that you've got. So later on, you can stick it to your forehead and everyone can see who you are. Maybe not that one, but anyway. So this is from 1 Peter 2. You're a chosen people. You're a royal priesthood, a holy nation, people belonging to God. You have received mercy. And in Ephesians, right at the beginning, the last one I'm going to read out before we move on to a video, it says this. We have redemption through his blood. We were chosen. We were predestined according to the plan of him who works everything in conformity with the purpose of his will. You were marked with the Holy Spirit to the praise of his glory. We are adopted, it says in verse 4, as his children through Jesus. So I don't know what you needed to hear this morning off that postcard. If we had been gathered together, I'd be able to give each one of you one of those postcards to remind you. But hopefully if you put it on a post-it note, you can put it somewhere to remind you all this week of who you are. You're a son and a daughter. You're an heir of the King of Kings. So we're going to watch a really short video about that now before we sing another song together.
Evening comes.
Lay tasks to rest.
Thoughts reflecting on the day.
The gifts you give.
The people you trust me with.
What an honour it is
to work within your plan.
You know my name.
For the work you give me, your strength sustains.
Yet I am more to you than instrument.
I am son, daughter, friend.
In my inmost, knit to you.
Inseparable.
Invaluable.
Loved.
Celebrated.
Heard.
Pursued.
Grace abounding.
Found in you.
My work could not win this gift from you.
And later on we'll be looking at praying that Lord's Prayer through together. So before Maddie brings us our Bible reading and Tim shares some thoughts with us, we're going to sing together. And I said last week, sometimes it's a bit weird this singing, isn't it? Sometimes it's tempting just to kind of sit and watch and maybe not join in. But I'd really encourage you, if you're comfortable to do so, to join in as you would at church. Or maybe even be aware that actually there's no one around you. So if you want to stand or raise your hands or anything like that, it's just between you and the Lord. There might be family with you, of course, but I'd encourage you to really enter in and to have an opportunity to worship, because we're doing this together. We might be scattered, as we saw in the image on my first, at the beginning of our service together, that scattered dots. We might be scattered, but we can join together as we worship the Lord. So let's sing together.
Deliverance from my enemies.
Amen. We're children of God. And now I'm going to have Maddie come to do our Bible reading. So thanks, Maddie.
Matthew chapter 6, verses 5 to 14. And when you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues, on the street corners to be seen by others. Truly I tell you, they have reserved their reward in full. But when you pray, go into your room, close your door, and pray to your Father who is unseen. Then your Father, who sees what is done in secret, will reward you. And when you pray, do not keep on babbling like the pagans, for they think they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them, for your Father knows what you need before you ask him. This then is how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. But deliver us from the evil one. For if you forgive other people when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. Amen.
Hi. I'm Tim, for those of you who haven't met me. It's lovely to have you with us here this morning at All In. I'm having a good time. So I've got some things for us to think about now. This morning, we've been thinking a little bit about our identity, about who we are, and the fact that whoever we are, Jesus calls us to be involved in bringing in God's kingdom. And so far, we've been focusing mainly on the blessings of our identity in God. We are God's children, and therefore we're God's heirs, and we can be secure in that identity. We know who our Heavenly Father is. We can rely on him. We can trust him. We're secure in that. It's fantastic. We are princes and princesses of God's kingdom, which is a great privilege. However, with great privilege, to paraphrase a little bit, comes great responsibility. Now, I've got some pictures to show you. Normally, I'd ask you to put your hands out or shout out as soon as you recognise who they are. I can't do that today, but maybe the first person to put the correct answer in the comments stream wins a prize, a virtual prize, probably. No actual prizes, and I can't throw chocolate that far, and I'm not David. So anyway, so here we go. Here's the first one. Well done to everybody who recognises Moana. So I wonder if you'll be as good at the second one. Here we go. This is, of course, Thor from the Marvel Universe incarnation of him. What about this one? Let's try this. Now, I wonder if anybody got this one. I suspect quite a few of you will know that she comes from the movie Brave. I wonder if you know her name. It is, of course, Merida. And our final one, let's try this. Last but not least is Hiccup. And extra points, kudos, and prizes, virtual prizes, if you got Toothless and Light Fury in there as well. So, what do all of these characters have in common, do you think? Well, maybe lots of things, but the thing that struck me is that they are all princes or princesses who we see through the course of the film, through the course of their story, grow into their role as leaders, and realise that there are privileges and there are responsibilities that come along with the privileges of being part of the royal family. And recently we've seen that worked out very publicly with Meghan and Harry, whatever you think about the whole thing. And to be honest, personally, I think that if they want to be out of the media spotlight and go and raise their family somewhere else, that's entirely understandable. Whatever we think about that, it's become very clear that if adult members of the royal family want to be royalty, then there's work to do. There are work to be done as representatives of the crown. And if they don't, for whatever reason, want to do that work, then they have to give up the title and some of the privileges that come with it. And we are sons and daughters of the King of Heaven, and we're representatives of that kingdom. As the cliche has it, perhaps, we are the only Bible that some people will ever read. We are the Jesus that people see. We're representatives of God's kingdom. And this prayer that Maddie read for us, that Jesus taught his friends, it begins with that amazing fact that we can say, "Our Father," to the God of heaven. So we've already said our identity and our ability and authority to go to God in prayer, all tied up in that relationship. And in the prayer, we go on to ask for things, that God's name is honoured, that God's rule and reign, God's values, God's kingdom will come. God's will be done here on earth as it is in heaven. And we ask for God to provide for us on a daily basis the things we need, our food, but also what we need spiritually, forgiveness. But we also commit ourselves to forgive those who have hurt us. And we ask for protection from evil and from temptation. I wonder, can you hear the responsibilities that are included here? How can we ask that God's will be done on earth if we're not seeking out and obeying God's commands to us? How can we pray that God's kingdom will come if we don't live by its values and aren't being ambassadors for the kingdom? How can we ask for forgiveness ourselves if we don't forgive others? So as God's children and heirs, we are to seek and live by God's will. We're to be ambassadors, representatives of God's kingdom, and we're to forgive others. Those are just some of our responsibilities. The great news is that we don't have to do those responsibilities on our own. We have the resources of heaven. We have the power of the Holy Spirit to help us do those things, to fulfill those responsibilities. And when we fail, which we will, there is forgiveness. We are forgiven. This isn't about being sent on a guilt trip, but there is a challenge perhaps here for us. We are called, all of us, whoever we are, to live out our Christian lives faithfully as Jesus' disciples on our front line. All of us are included, young, old, women, men, employed, unemployed, well off, or just scraping by. We are all sons and daughters of the King, heirs of the kingdom, and are all ambassadors and agents for that kingdom. Let's live like it. Amen.
Amen. Thanks, Tim, for that challenge and encouragement. And we're going to reflect on that as we sing our next song, King of Kings, Majesty. And maybe as Tim was talking, you knew that there's something in your heart, some forgiveness in your heart that you need to work through. And maybe during this song, there's that moment to have that time with the Lord and to acknowledge that and to seek him. Let's sing together. I lay my all. Thank you so much, Lucy, for leading us in worship today. And we've had lots of comments about our missing worshipping together. And I know exactly what you mean. It's lovely to be able to worship together like this, but we look forward, don't we, to that day, whenever it'll be, or we can gather in the church building again. And I get the feeling it's going to be a good morning. It might even go on a bit longer than usual. Who knows? Who knows? Anyway, we're going to come to a time of prayer now, and this is going to be structured around the Lord's Prayer, that one that begins, Our Father, the reminder that above all we're His children, our Father in heaven. And the way we're doing it today, so the whole of our prayer time is going to be based around the Lord's Prayer, and we'd like you please to join in at home, wherever you are, in the comments, and we're going to take it kind of a phrase at a time. It's going to be signed, so there'll be BSL as well going on, and what we'd like you to do is comment with each phrase. With some words or thoughts, or might even be Bible readings or Bible words that come to mind. So, for example, when I say Our Father in heaven, we might want to all say that together. When the slide comes up, we'll say Our Father in heaven. And then you might want to say out loud or type in things like light surrounds you, or wow, your heavenly throne is awesome, or you're our dad, or thank you for loving me, or thank you for creating me, or something like that. And we'll see how this goes. And we'll also have Dawn and Kimberly signing this as well. So if you'd like to join in with signing it as we go, please do. So let's begin. Our Father in heaven, you're our Father. You're on your throne. Light surrounds you. You are holy. Thank you for loving me. You reign. Hallowed be your name. You are holy, holy, holy. May we take you seriously. May everyone see your perfection. You are the King. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. In Wellington, in Shropshire, would your way be known? Would your rule and reign be evident in our lives, in our communities? You are most high and holy. Creation reveals your glory. Give us today our daily bread. What we need for now. You are our provider. Help us to trust you. We think of those who have nothing. Thank you for loving me and always being there with me. Have your way among us. You are the one true God. You give us all we need, Lord. You provide for all our needs. Thank you. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. This is hard. This is difficult. Holy Spirit, come, help us. If we are holding chains against people, if we're holding ourselves in chains through unforgiveness for ourselves, we need your help. In the name of Jesus, would you release us from shame and bitterness? Help us to forgive. Help us to let go of those that hurt me. Break the chains of unforgiveness and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Protect us, please. Help us to stand firm. Help us to love ourselves. Help me let go of those that hurt me. Protect us. We pray, Lord, your angels around our homes, our families, our friends. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord, you are great, you are sovereign, you are the King of Kings, you're the Lord of the Lords, you're the Alpha and the Omega, the firstborn from among the dead. You rule, you reign, your kingdom come. All power, all glory in all ages is yours. You made us, you love us, you know us. You are everything, who was and is to come. We praise you, Jesus. We worship you, name above all names. You're glorious. You're wonderful and true. You're powerful, God. You're glorious. You're beautiful. You're wonderful. Oh, Jesus, we love you and we love your presence. Amen. Amen. Do continue praying in the comments. We're coming to an end of our morning here together. When we've sung a song and said a short prayer, do join us in one of our Zoom rooms. They'll be coming up on the last screen. We've just got a couple today. We've got one as a general coffee and catch up, and then one for the children that might be missing seeing each other. So there might be quite a lot there, and then we'll see what else we can get up to. Thanks so much for sharing some of your pictures. I'm going to be sharing them in a second. But there was a sense, what I think, as we were praying for that idea that God calls us to be a people of forgiveness. And for some of us, that's really difficult. But especially for some of us, it's really difficult to forgive ourselves, isn't it? It's really easy to hold on to things that are chains from the past, mistakes we've made, regrets that we have, things that we know we shouldn't have done. It's really easy to hold on to them. But the Bible says that as far as the east is from the west, and that's a long way, that's how far he has removed our transgression. That's how far he's removed our sin. He's taken that away. That was what the cross was all about. That was what the resurrection was all about. That when we come to Jesus, all our sins are washed away. And we are washed white, as whiter than snow. And so this morning, if something you're struggling with is forgiving yourself, we're going to sing a final song, and it reminds us of who we are. And I'd encourage you to sing it out as a prayer, that we are who he says we are. And if this morning maybe you're tuning in for the first time and you don't yet, you wouldn't say that you're a Christian or that you've got a relationship with Jesus and you'd like to know more, please get in touch with us. If you'd like to know more about what it means to being a Christian, you don't have to have all the answers. Thank goodness, because I certainly don't. But it's a turning from the old ways to the new as we turn from our old life and say, you know what, Jesus, I want to try and follow you. I turn from that and I come and I want to follow you. And if that's you this morning, please do get in touch. We'd love to pray with you. You can drop us a message on the Facebook page. You can drop me an email. My name's David. You can drop Tim an email, or Nick or Caroline. One of us, our emails are all on the website, or drop us a message. But let's sing our final song, Who You Say I Am, as a declaration of our identity in Jesus. Let's sing together. Well, it's been really good to have you with us this morning. As promised, some pictures of what's been going on around the various homes in Wellington this morning. This is from Fraser and Emily McKinnon. Thank you very much for sending them in. Fraser joining in with the game of, I think he's the Hulk, and Emily on in bed watching church, happy days with cake. Well, that's good. And I'm sure, hopefully, that all over the place you've been getting involved and having your fun with your post-it notes. But just remember that no matter what you might say about yourself, no matter what others might say about yourself, and that might be good, it might not be as good, but above all, we listen to who God says we are, that we're chosen, that we're his children, and that we're his heirs. And with that comes blessing but with that also comes, wherever we are, a bit of responsibility. Anyway, we're going to be logging off soon. A reminder that we've got some Zoom rooms, so they're going along in that corner. You'll be able to see the Zoom room key. There's one for the children, and there's also one for the just a general coffee and catch up. And I'm aware it's going quite slowly, so there it is. I'm aware it's going quite slowly, so if you, unless you're pretty quick with a pen, I will write them down in the comments for you. But it's, I mean, in fact, Caroline can hopefully write down in the comments the children's one to save me doing that, and I can write down the other one. But it's been really good to have you with us. Thanks for all your help with Food Bank. Please continue sending them into one of those donation points. If you know someone that, or you yourself want to know more about the Christian faith, please do get in touch with Nick. We've got an Alpha call starting on the 1st of May, which we'd love you to be part of. It's been great for you to joining with us this morning. Thanks so much for logging on. Next Sunday morning, I'll be leading our communion service, and we've got Sean coming to speak to us. Now, Sean is the son-in-law of Jonathan and Heather, so it'd be lovely for you to log on and hear what he has to say to us. He is a missionary that, as a church, we support, so we look forward to welcoming him. Caroline has just put the key for the kids' room in the comments, so 116-452-679. But before we log off, I'm going to say a prayer. And you know what, if you're this morning, I'm going to say a prayer, especially for those of you that might be struggling with that forgiveness of yourself. That's really on my heart this morning. So I'm going to say a prayer. You might want to repeat it after me. And then we're going to say a prayer for everyone, a blessing. And I think to finish, we'll just play that song again, Who You Say I Am. And that'll be the end of it. So I won't be coming up after that, in case you want to continue to worship. But let's just say a prayer. So Father God, thank you so much for all you've done today. Thank you so much for all we've seen you do and all we've seen you being a part of. And we pray, Lord, especially for those this morning that are struggling with forgiving themselves, the forgiveness of themselves. And if that's you this morning, I want to say a prayer, do say afterwards. Father, I confess my struggle to forgive myself to you. Lord, I believe that I am your child and that you love me. I believe that I am forgiven, so help me by your Spirit to know that forgiveness. Help me to know I'm your child and I am loved by you. Amen. And a prayer for all of us. Father God, we go with your blessing, with your power, that we might know the blessings and responsibilities that come with being your child. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, let's have that wonderful song led by Lucy to finish with. And we'll see you hopefully this week. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't. Like our Facebook page to stay up to date with all that we've got going on. But bless you guys. We'll see you during the week or next week. Do continue chatting in the comments. Hopefully see you on the Zoom room. See you later. Bless you. Bye.
Child.
Amen. Well, I know I promised not to pop back on, but I've got to give Chris Pickering a shout out for his sausage sandwich delivery to me and Kimberly. So, Chris Pickering, you know what? Absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much. I have put tomato ketchup in mine. I think Kimberly's more of a brown sauce kind of person. But anyway, there we go. In a full circle, we did a bit of sauce and condiments and sausage rolls. We did a lot about Jesus, and it was really good. Big circle, all the way back to sausage sandwiches. So anyway, we're logging off now. Do join us in Zoom. Do subscribe to YouTube and Facebook, and we will see you next week, hopefully with some stories of all that God's been up to in your life as we go, knowing that we are children of the King. And that he loves us no matter what. So bless you guys, and we'll see you later.